For some reason, many conservative Christians have not embraced the idea of going green. But imagine if by throwing yourself into environmentalism, you could save tens of thousands of dollars a year and get a better relationship with God. The Sleeth family of Wilmore, Kentucky, prove it can be done.
The Sleeth family are Prius driving, bike riding, veggie growing environmentalists, but they're also evangelical Christians.
Matthew Sleeth lays out why every Christian should embrace creation care and serve God, save the planet.
I believe the Bible, and the Bible tells me to take care of creation.
And his wife Nancy shows step by step how it could save you more than $37,000 this year if you implemented all the hundreds of green tips in her book, Go Green, Save Green.
If you drew a Venn diagram of frugality and creation care, taking care of the environment, they overlap about 90% of the time.
At the root of the word conservative, and I'm a conservative, is to conserve.
The Sleeth showed us some of their favorite savings you can get inside your home, like turning your water heater down to 120 degrees.
You don't need water any hotter than what you need for a shower.
Insulate your hot water pipes with these simple sleeves you can cut to length and slip on.
This is a real quick fix.
Pretty inexpensive?
Very inexpensive. I think it's like $20, $30 to do all the pipes in the basement.
Matthew also stuffed his attic with insulation a foot and a half thick. He changes the filters for his home's heating and cooling system once a month and gets the system itself tuned up yearly.
It's maintenance people forget about, but you'll actually save money and it'll be safer.
They recommend you heat 3 degrees less in the winter and cool 3 degrees less in the summer. Most of the time they want it cooler, they use ceiling fans instead of the AC. Put up line curtains and install double or triple pane windows that can keep heat in during the cold months and heat out during the hot months. And they've set up a summer kitchen outside so they don't need to use their oven during hot days.
Why should I be turning the heat up in my house by turning it up to 350 degrees and then fighting that with an air conditioning unit?
The Sleeths buy only Energy Star appliances, meaning they're the most energy efficient, and then they use energy saving principles, like with their fridge.
You should keep your freezer and your refrigerator as full as possible. The more full it is, the less energy it will use.
They also use the cold rather than colder setting.
The only problem you might have is slightly softer ice cream, but it's not a health hazard at all to keep it on the warmest setting possible.
They also recommend using ice cube trays and disconnecting your ice maker because it uses heat to drop ice cubes into the bucket.
So you're heating up your freezer, which makes no sense. It's like driving a car uphill with your emergency brake on.
When it comes to a washing machine, the Sleeths always use the cold setting and bought a front rather than top loader because it only uses a third of the water.
The water only has to come up to about here, and it throws the clothes through it.
They only wash when there's a full load, though they found they save so much energy hand-washing their dishes, they turned their dishwasher into a spice rack. They also didn't buy a dryer, instead hanging clothes in their basement and out back.
It's a solar clothes dryer, yeah.
They admit hanging clothes and washing dishes by hand take extra time, but they use that time as a major source of fellowship, both with each other and with the Lord.
I'm going to go hang the clothes and pray.
One place you can save time, as well as money and energy, is the bathroom, where Matthew recommends shaving a couple of minutes off your shower, or maybe even trying what the thriftiest showerers do.
Get water on them, turn the water off, then shave, shampoo, all that sort of thing, then rinse off.
And showering, with low-flow shower heads, instead of taking a bath, saves many gallons of water.
About a tenth of what a full bathtub would use.
The toilet is a major waster of water, so the Sleeths recommend placing a brick and 1 gallon jug in each toilet tank.
So each time it uses a gallon and a brick less water to flush.
You can reap big savings by replacing your incandescent light bulbs with compact fluorescents or LEDs. If every household changed just five,
it'd be the same as taking 8 million cars off the road. And we could shut down 21 coal-fired plants.
All this has brought their power bill down to just $13 to $17 a month. They're also living healthier because of doing things like putting in bamboo floors and getting rid of carpets and fabricated flooring that released harmful chemicals inside. They're making their own cleaning products out of non-toxic substances like vinegar and baking soda. And they're eating healthier and cheaper by consuming more beans and grains, which they buy in bulk, and fruits and vegetables.
Rather than focusing on meat and sweets and prepackaged foods.
And they grow many of those veggies they eat in their own organic garden. All of this, from the bamboo floors to the simpler diet, isn't just about going green, but getting back to the simple basics, because
the closer you can be to God-made things, the healthier your family will be.
And the Sleeths believe that means spiritual as well as financial and physical health. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Wilmore, Kentucky.